So everything we've done so far has simply put the data back to the user. In other words, it's been interactive, but it hasn't really done what we often do with applications on the web, and that is save the data for others or save it for later or whatever else. Or, for example, if you wanted to get input from a user and accumulate that, what would you do? So we're going to do one way of doing that now, and that is rather than just printing out the data that the person just submitted, which is what we've done so far, let's go ahead and save that to a file. How do we do that? Well, the first thing we have to do is we start the PHP here is we need to open up a file, and we're going to do that using a what's called a file handle. So a handle is this is going to be a really bad metaphor because you are probably all too young to remember when oil came in cans, and it was an oil can, and in order to actually pour the oil into your car, you had to attach a handle to it, and it kind of opened up the can and gave you a way to pour out the contents. That's kind of what a file handle is. It's kind of taking a file and opening it up and giving you something to hold on to. So we're going to go ahead and open a file by using fopen, and then we say the name of the file. In this case, we're just going to use dump.txt. This means, because I haven't given it a full all the slashes needed, it means that it's opening it in the local directory, wherever the PHP file is. You'd rarely do this, but for now it'll work. And then you have to have a one-letter thing that says what you're going to do with it. You might be reading that file, for example, or you might be writing to it. The problem is when you write to it, if it already exists, it's just going to overwrite it. In this case, we're going to do one that we use, again, very rarely, A for append. That means adding on to whatever file might already exist there. We could stop right there because that would have given us assigned the handle to something. But what happens if it runs into problems along the way? We wouldn't have any way of knowing. So we're going to do something called or die. Or die means if for some reason this doesn't work, just stop there. Just give up. Die already. And usually it's good to have a gasping last breath when you die. Something along the lines of could not open file. So we know why you've died, okay? So basically what happens now is if it can't open this file to append to it, it's just going to die and it won't do anything else left on this page. It will stop processing. So this is good because otherwise it would have tried to open this and failed and then kept going and then we would have run into trouble. Okay, we aren't going to do an HTML because we're dumping it into a file, right? Actually, let's go ahead and do a quick fwrite, which is to write. And where do we want to write? To our file handle, of course, to the thing we've opened up. We're just going to do a quick line of dashes so we can separate out a new record. And then I'm going to do a backslash n, which is a new line. That means go to the next line. If we just did this, it would start the next write right after this, and we just get a very long line of text. We really want to split it up, and to do that we need to use this special character, which means go to the next line, new line. All right, and so down here now, instead of echoing, we're going to file write. I can spell that correctly. And we're going to again go to our file handle, and this time we're going to put in our x. So before we were echoing that, now we're writing it out to a file. We don't need that echo because we aren't using list items, but we do need again to have a quick again to the file handle. We do need to write a quick new line here so that we make sure that each of these things is on its own line. So I think that's it. I think if we save this, it should work. File save, and we'll go ahead and upload it to the server. And yes, we're okay with overwriting. And we'll go ahead and, as we did before, submit this form. Now it didn't output anything, but remember in the new version of this we aren't really outputting anything. All we have is this P. We haven't echoed anything to the screen at all. Oops, that shouldn't be there anymore because we have a close UL when we haven't opened a UL. Oops, we don't need that UL either. So we're not actually putting anything to the screen, so it's not surprising that it doesn't output anything. What it should be doing is appending to a new file, which we have right there. And let's go ahead and bring that back down from the server and see what it's put in that new file. We'll open it up. just what we expected. Now, if we do it again, I'm going to go back and some other user comes along and decides they only want to invite Imelda, and they hit go and it says, here goes. And then we'll go ahead and download the new version of that. Hopefully, if we've done this right, it appends. That means it adds on to that file. So if we take a look, yes. See, it's added on a new record. So we could put that up there and thousands of people could add record after record and we'd have some kind of record from it. It's a little hard to get to. We have to use FTP, but we know how to do that.